This is Dr. P.J. Patil, Mechanical Engineering Department, TKIT, Varnagar.
This is Dr. N.S. Dharashankar, Mechanical Engineering Department, TKIT, Varnagar.
Today we are going to demonstrate the experiment, determination of mass moment of inertia of connecting rod by using compound pendulum method. Generally, this is the connecting rod. This connecting rod is irregular shaped body. Here there is no standard formula is available for the determining radius of gyration or locate the CG, center of gravity of the connecting rod. So this connecting rod, this is the small end, this is the big end. This is the small end and this is the big end. In the manual, the mass of this connecting rod is given. Also, the small end diameter is given, that is small d. Also, capital N d, diameter of big end is given, that is capital D. So here you can give this dimension, small d and capital D. Now, with the help of vernier or scale, you can measure the distance between these two centers, distance between small end center and big end center, that is defined as L. So here, this is the L. Now, during experiment, we are going to find out time period by suspending it in the small end. Also, we find out the time period by suspending it at the big end. So, generally, compound pendulum means the body which is suspended, rigid body which is suspended vertically and oscillate under the gravitational force with small oscillation or small amplitude, that is called as compound pendulum. So we treat this connecting rod as a compound pendulum, suspended it vertically and give disturbance to it so that it can oscillate with small amplitude and measure the time. So now we are going to conduct the experiment procedure. So here, this is the point of the suspension. Now initially, I suspend this connecting rod vertically at small end and give disturbance to it and measure the time required for n number of cycles. So during experiment, first we kept n is 10, for second observation we kept n as a 50 and for third observation we kept n as a 20. So 10, 15 and 20 we measure the time period for that particular cycles with the help of stopwatch. Now repeat the same procedure by suspending it at big end. So here this connecting rod is suspended vertically at big end. Now disturb it and measure the time required for again 10 oscillations, 15 oscillations and 20 oscillations. And particular observations are recorded in the observation table. Now next part, that is observation and observation table and conclusion, is explained by my colleagues Dr. N.S. Dhawan.
Observe that time for 10 cycles is 0.77 seconds, time for 15 cycles it is 0.79 seconds and time for 20 cycles it is 0.81 seconds. In the same way, when the body is suspended at the big end, now observe that time for 10 cycles is 0.61 seconds, time for 15 cycles is 0.66 seconds and time for 20 cycles is 0.69 seconds. Now the mean of these three has been taken, it is observed to be 0.672. From the small end, the mean is 0.783 seconds. Now let us move towards the calculations. In the calculations, L is equal to A plus B. L is equal to A plus B and is the distance between the big end diameter, center of big end diameter and the small end diameter. It is A plus B. It is nothing but 0.165 meter. Now this is the formula TPS. What is TPS? It is the time which is the time period which is considered by considering the by suspending the connecting rod from the small end. It is equal to 2 pi under root k k square plus l dash square divided by g into l dash. That is k square plus l dash square divided by g into l dash. What is the distance l dash? L dash distance is the distance between the CG and the suspended point of the small end. This is the suspended point of the small end. So this distance is considered as L dash. Now the mean time period from which is calculated by suspending it from the small end has been considered. That is nothing but 0.783. It is equal to 2 pi into under root k square. K it is not known to me. K is nothing but the radius of direction. It is not known to me. Plus L dash. So how to find out the L dash? That we are going to see here. What is L dash? This is A. This is the A and this is going to be the radius. This is going to be the radius. That is nothing but D by 2. That is nothing but D by 2. So this distance from the center of the small end at CG is nothing but A. That is nothing but A. And this distance is R. I want the distance of suspension from the small end. That is nothing but small D by 2. That is nothing but small D by 2. That is k square plus a plus b by 2 bracket square divided by g into a plus b by 2. Now put the values, corresponding values, and after solving you will get k square is equal to a square minus 0.1352a minus 0.0013. So here we have substituted a. A is unknown to me. It is not known to me. But D is known to me. This is nothing but the small a diameter. That is nothing but 0.017 meter. So it is 0.017 divided by 2. So in this way, you get one equation. What is equation 2? It is nothing but k square is equal to a square minus 0.135a minus 0.0013. Again, the connecting rod is suspended from the beacon. Now, it is nothing but TPB is equal to 2 pi under root k square plus L double dash bracket square divided by g into L double dash. What is L double dash? L double dash, it is nothing but the distance of suspension from the big end at the CG. Distance of suspension from the big end at the CG. So, this distance is B. This is the center distance between the CG and the center of this big end diameter. That is B. But I am interested in finding out the distance L double dash. It is nothing but B plus capital D by 2. It is nothing but A square plus B plus capital D by 2 bracket square. What is the value of D, capital D? It is given here. It is nothing but 0.052 meter, or it is 52 millimeter. Now, put the values here and solve this equation. What is TPB? It is nothing but 0.672 seconds per cycle. It is equal to 2 pi into bracket k square plus, it is b plus 0.052 divided by 2 bracket square divided by g. It is nothing but 9.81 into b plus 0.052 divided by 2. To put the values and solve this equation, you get k square is equal to b square minus 0.062b minus 0.0029. This is nothing but equation number 3. Now, this is the value for k square, this is also the value for the k square. So, when you equate these two equations, equation number 2 and 3, you will get the value of b as 0.049 meter, and the value of A, it is nothing but 0.116 meter. Now this is nothing but the distance B, that is the location of CG from the big end center. If you consider this connecting rod, what is the center of gravity? It is nothing but a point at which whole mass of the body, it is supposed to be concentrated.
It is a point at which whole mass of the body it is supposed to be concentrated. Now the CG is deviating towards the big end because the measure mass is deviated towards the big end. If you observe it, this is a small end and this is the big end. So measure mass is deviated towards the big end. So our value of B is nothing but 0.049 meter. So it is situated somewhat here. So our answers are correct. If it would have, if A would have less than the B, then it would have wrong. But B is coming as 0.049. B is less than A. So the distance A is nothing but 0.116 meter and distance B is nothing but 49 millimeter or it is nothing but 2.49 meter. Now put these values in equation 2. You put these values in this equation 2 so that you will get the value of K. It is nothing but the radius of gyration as 0.065 meter. You get the value as 0.065 meter. And you know what is the formula to find out the mass moment of inertia. It is nothing but I is equal to mk square. Already you know the mass of the connecting rod. It is nothing but 0.185 kg of 185 gram. So the mass moment of inertia is nothing but 0.185 into this 0.065 square. I is equal to mk square. It is 0.185 into 0.065 square. So the total mass moment of inertia is nothing but 7.81 into 10⁻⁴ kg meter square. Thank you very much.